faster, Mr. B! Don't make me carry you!
Hey guys, back with a new video. Today I'm doing Subject Delta from NECA's Bioshock 2 figure line, their player series Bioshock 2, whatever. This little doll does not come with him. She's there just for looks. This is Eleanor as a little sister, but she's just there to hang out, and she's gonna fall over now that I moved her. That's gonna happen. Delta is who you play in Bioshock 2. He was the first successful Big Daddy in the Prototype Alpha series, and he does look a bit different from Mr. Bubbles here. You can tell a pretty big difference, and there's a little size comparison for you there. Pretty cool little guy here. The detail for this figure is interesting because he comes with all the little doodads. Since Delta could use plasmids in the game, he comes with all of his little injection ports so you can shoot the Eve directly into him. His fingertips are not left exposed, but that's not really a big deal. With the plasmids, you need to have bare skin to use them, and he had little holes in his fingertips to use them. He does have his little camera on top. All of his hoses are there. You do have to connect the hoses when you get them out of the packaging, but that's not really a big deal. I do have a problem with this being so floppy. Well, like, it could be a little more sturdy. The backpack fits right on. Everything is detailed nicely. I love the Bioshock figures. This is definitely my favorite NECA line, probably of all time. He has overall nice metallic look to all of the metal bits. And it just really, it looks like actual copper, like actual bronze, what's actually used in the diving suit. But it looks very, very well done. The diving suit has a nice texture to it. All the rope, everything just really sparkles and shines with me. And I do like it quite a bit. He does come with a little diving knife that you can't take out. And that's really it for him. He does come with one accessory. The Alpha series were like this, but they had the ability to use the drill of the later Big Daddies. So as a bonus accessory, go ahead and grab his arm, give a nice little tug, pegs right out. Take this one, peg it right back in, and yeah, I do have a slight problem. The peg on the drill doesn't really fit in place as well as it should. I've tried the whole crazy glue trick and to kind of thicken it up, and I think it worked a little bit, but it doesn't really stay in there as well as it should. But there is Alpha with his drill arm. Really, really does look good. And I think the drill can actually spin. Although it is rather sharp for just plastic, so I'd be careful. But you can't do that. I think the drill arm can actually come off, but I'm not really going to mess with that. There's really no point. These little hoses do disconnect rather easily. You may want to actually glue them in place. I'm really considering it. They hold it nicely, but playing with it, fiddling with it, they do come undone. So that could be a slight problem. Articulation-wise for him, though, he's got quite a bit. These guys are a bit more agile than the regular Big Daddies, these guys there. So he has a bit more poseability with them. No head movements. His waist can rotate. And it does have kind of a slight kind of pivot swivel kind of thing to it. You can kind of get it forward and back as well. The arms swing out to the sides pretty far. And they do move forward and back. The elbow does bend. It is worth noting that when I got mine, the elbow for his other arm, this one here, would not bend at all. A big thanks to NECA. I contacted them, I explained the problem, and they sent me a replacement arm. So now this joint moves very, very freely. And that is a problem that does happen with any kind of figure line. They get paint in the joint, and it really does make it stiff and hard to move. But a big thanks to NECA for replacing that part for me. I'm not sure if I actually thanked them when it happened, but big thanks for that. So the elbow does bend, it does rotate at the elbow, and his wrist has forward and back movement, and it does rotate. You go to his leg, and the knife does kind of get in the way. The leg can swing around pretty far, and also it has a joint built in, if I can get it. I think one actually moves a little better. There you go. The legs can actually swing out to the side very, very far compared to the Big Daddy, or the original Big Daddy. The knee can bend, rotate at the knee. The boot has all this full movements, and he is really loaded down with articulation. It's really fun to look at a figure like this, compare it to an old NECA figure that doesn't have a lot of poseability, and kind of see how they're improving over time. I'm gonna be honest, NECA a few years ago, I wasn't a huge fan. I was like, that's a statue. But these figures really do set the bar for what NECA can do. I love the Bioshock line. I really do. And a fun little thing, if you plug his regular arm back in, that one really gotta force it in there. But in the game, Delta could also use Rosie's rivet gun. It's not a perfect fit. The hand wasn't really sculpted for, I don't think. But you can fit her gun, I'm gonna call it her even though it's a guy, in his hand fairly well. It's not a perfect fit. It does kind of droop. and I just dropped it. But if you find that one little spot where it does have enough kind of friction to hold it in place, you can even get him kind of posed, and I'm dropping it, so let's try this again. There we go. You can kind of pose him with it if you so desire, and that's just kind of a basic what you can do. It's nice that you can use the other accessories with him, and also, it's worth noting, recently there was a repaint of him brought out as Subject, I think, Omega. And Omega comes with a newly sculpted hand made to hold the grenade launcher, which is done very nicely. I'll cover more about this when I get to Omega. But you can fit this in Delta's hand, and it's not a perfect fit. It is rather loose because his hand wasn't really made to hold it. But if you get it balanced in there, he can hold the grenade launcher to some extent. I know I'm not really doing a very good job showing it off. But he can hold it. Although it is rather loose. You gotta kind of find a little balance, but it's possible. You can kind of toy around with it. And that's all I can really say for Delta. If you are a fan of Bioshock 2, then most likely you like Delta. And I would say pick it up. It's a great looking figure. He'll run you about 15 bucks, I think, at most stores. I've seen him for 10 occasionally. Not very often. But if you're a fan of Bioshock, Bioshock 2, chances are you're going to want this guy. He's a great addition to the Bioshock figure line. And I'm glad I got it. So, that's all I can really say. Hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.